I'm in the Detroit Institute of Art, and I'm with my sister Kathleen. And we're going to take a tour of the museum and bring you along.
The Detroit Institute of Art was founded in 1885. Originally located on Jefferson Street in downtown Detroit, the museum and its collection soon outgrew this space and moved into a larger Beaux-Arts building on Woodward Avenue in 1927. The new building was designed by French-born Philadelphia architect Paul-Philippe Cray, who was born in Lyon and moved to Philadelphia to teach at the University of Pennsylvania. Since Cray's design, north and south wings were added on in the 1960s, and the museum recently finished a large expansion in 2007. Let's go look around. One of the highlights in the museum for me was this 16th century French chapel made of limestone with stained glass windows. Another was by Artemesia Gentileschi, one of the first female artists to gain success in the 17th century. The museum has her painting, Judith and her Maidservant, with the Head of Holofernes from 1622 to 25. John Everett Millais, the English Pre-Raphaelite artist, painted this work in Detroit's collection, The Leisure Hours of 1863, after his time as a member of the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood. During the end of the 1850s and the beginning of the 1860s, Millais moved away from the religious subject matter and bright colors of the PRB and transitioned toward a more painterly style in hopes of public approval. One of the most well-known works of the museum is Mexican muralist Diego Rivera's Detroit Industry Fresco Cycle, which Rivera created as tribute to the city's workers in the 1930s. Composed of 27 panels, Rivera depicted men and large machines and factories hard at work. There is a rhythm to the frescoes, and as you stand in the court, you can imagine the movement of the assembly line. Rivera completed the frescoes over 11 months and finished them in 1933. The last area of the museum we looked at was the contemporary art section. We looked at this work by George Siegel of a man hunched over and walking between a wall and wooden scaffolding. Sylvia Plimick Mangold's landscape painting, Zodiacal Light of 1980. Richard Long's Stone Line, created in 1978. And finally, a work by Nancy Graves, whose art revolves around natural phenomena. Her piece in Detroit, Variability of Similar Forms, is made up of 36 replicas of camel leg bones, each similar to the one next to it, but not identical. Fascinated by camels, Graves arranges the legs made of steel, wax, marble, and wood, like trees, suggesting a forest of their legs.